Now, power on your laptop, go to raspberrypi.org, download Raspbian. It will take a while. Once it's done, extract Raspbian image from zip file. Insert an empty microSD card in microSD card reader. And now, connect it to USB port of your laptop. Bring up HR application and burn Raspbian OS on your microSD card. Again, this will take a while. Once flashing of Raspbian on microSD card is done, don't remove microSD card yet, as we need to do some configuration in order to enable Wi-Fi and SSH. To configure Wi-Fi, copy address of Raspbian root directory. Open a terminal and become root user. CD into Raspbian root directory and modify file named interfaces like so. We need to modify one more file named wp_supplicant.conf. Once done, create an empty file named ssh in boot directory and unmount your SD card. Finally, take out microSD card from microSD card reader and put it in Raspberry Pi. Now connect your SPI OLED display according to this connection guideline with your Raspberry Pi. Once done, power on your Raspberry Pi and scan your network using tools like Angry IP Scanner to find IP address of Raspberry Pi. Now, SSH into your Raspberry Pi. First thing to do is enable SPI interface. Once done, reboot your Raspberry Pi. SSH into your Raspberry Pi one more time. Now, clone Raspberry Pi guy's Git repository using this command. Once done, you should see a directory called OLED in your home directory. Go inside OLED directory. There you will find a file called OLED install.sh. Run it using this command. This will again take a while. Now clone my Git repository using this command. Once done, you will see a directory called Raspberry Pi Vital Monitor via OLED. In this directory, you will see a file called OLED mem_cpu.py. Copy that file into python-examples directory of Raspberry Pi guy's OLED directory. Now change your directory to python examples and type this command to execute OLED mem_cpu.py file. It will ask you for sleep time. On providing sleep time, script will error out saying apt-get not found. Just because we are missing a package. You can install it using this command: sudo apt-get install sysstat. On installing it and executing script for one more time, you will see a beautiful OLED screen with your Raspberry Pi steps on it. Python code contained in OLED mem_cpu.py file is pretty straightforward. If you face any issues, let me know through comments. I have also included an rc.local file. You can replace this file in your /etc directory to turn on OLED automatically every time Raspberry Pi boots. Well, that's it for this video, guys. I'll see you soon with another video. Till then, take care.